Hi there, would you like to do an experiment with me? All right, well, I've got this little vial with this clear liquid in it. So I'm gonna handle this just because this was on a hot plate, and this chemical here is a skin irritant. So I've got some gloves on. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a little crystal from the base vial, and I'm gonna drop it into here. And it's going to be a little bit of a seed crystal. And we'll watch everything crystallize. So I'll drop that in there. And then we're going to just watch this for a few minutes and see what happens. And while that's going on, I want to talk to you a little bit about crystals. So, have you ever seen a crystal like one of these before? Yeah, this is an amethyst crystal, and it's got a lot of nice colors on it. What about a crystal like this one? Yeah, this is called bismuth, and it's got a lot of really pretty colors on it too. What about a crystal like this? Have you ever seen a crystal like one of these? Yeah, it turns out all the metals that you encounter in your everyday life, those are crystals as well. So we have here, this is a piece of galvanized steel, and so do you see all these little flakes that are in here? These are all little crystals that are smushed together, kind of like in this amethyst here. If we were to make a model of what these crystals look like in this one here, all these little balls are going to represent atoms. And you can see how they form these really nice, tight patterns. And there are some places where the pattern gets disrupted. And that's what we call the crystal boundaries between the two grains. And so that would be like where we have two different crystals here or two different crystals here. Now, all of these crystals are defined by what's called a unit cell, which is the smallest chunk of that pattern. Do you want to make one of your own? All right, here's what I want you to do. I want you to take this piece of paper, and you're going to fold it in half three times. And then once you've done that, you're going to take a hole puncher, and I want you to punch five holes in it, however you want. All right, and then once you're finished with that, I'm going to have you unfold it, and you'll get a nice little pattern like this. And this is your crystal pattern. So scientists and engineers are interested in crystals for a lot of different uses. One that you might be familiar is in computers. So in this center area here, there are thousands of little crystals that scientists have engineered to run all sorts of different things. So you'll find crystals like that in your cell phones and in your computers. And I have here another little crystal that has a unique optical property. So if you look through this crystal at the text, you might notice something kind of interesting. Yeah, it kind of looks like the text here is it's a little blurry, or like almost like you're seeing double on it. So I have here, this is what's called a polarizer. And I'm going to put this on top, and I'm going to rotate it. And you tell me if you can see anything different with the text as I do that. Yeah, so you can kind of see the text go from double to single and back to double again. So these types of crystals can be used for a lot of different things, like the computers that we were talking about, to LEDs, or even to make new lasers. So do you have any questions? All right, well, thank you very much.